Hey, Shawn here from 3M. Really appreciate you joining me for this video today. What we're going to talk about here is our dynamic mixing system. And this system's been out for a while, but we started to notice that a lot of maybe newcomers to the industry or just guys that haven't seen it for a while maybe could use a little reintroduction. So we're going to show you some of the advantages and benefits of using this system. Before I get started, a couple things I want to cover. Number one, make sure we're using the proper personal protection equipment. So today's video, I'm going to use adhesives. So I'm going to make sure that I'm using a respirator. I'm going to glove up with some gloves, and then I'm going to have my safety glasses on as well. Also keep in mind, these videos were designed for a professional setting like a body shop. Also, if you have any questions about the safety or our warranties, we'll leave a link in the description below. Okay, so this is, we call it DMS, but DMS stands for dynamic mixing system. So let's talk about that a little bit. The reason we call it that is because the mixing nozzle actually spins. So there's a drive rod that goes through this machine and it turns this mixer inside. So that's why we call it a dynamic mixer as opposed to a static mixing nozzle, which is probably what you're used to. So this spins inside and gives you a much better uniform mix. So it's a very easy product to use. So DMS or dynamic mixing system, some of the advantages here are, number one, we have larger cartridges with larger volumes. Okay, so this is a 600 mil compared to our hand applicator products that are 200 milliliters. So a lot more product in there, and that gives you the advantage of less waste. So, you know, you walk around a body shop, you see all these smaller cartridges that are half full or maybe just a little bit left, and they sit around, dry out, go to waste. These, you can use the entire cartridge. So it goes a longer ways, less change out. You're doing a large roof or a you know, side of a van or whatever. You don't have to change out your cartridges as frequently as well. So a lot of advantages to having that larger cartridge. Another advantage is faster application. So you're gonna see here, I'm gonna do a demonstration coming up that I can apply a lot more product a lot quicker. And this is really where we see a lot of the interest with the guys now, where we show them this. So a lot of them have not even been aware that we have this in seam sealers and adhesives. We also have it in the body filler. This is what it first came out with, which was what guys were accustomed to. But they haven't seen these two products in here. And if you're doing, again, a lot of seam sealing, it's gonna be much quicker. Now the advantage to faster application is you have a longer working time or open time, right? So let's say you're doing a large panel like a roof skin and you're using panel bonding adhesive, you have 90 minutes. Well, if it takes you 10, 15 minutes just to apply all three applications to the host panel, to the part, and then one more bead for squeeze out, that's three trips around that huge roof. Number one, your arm's gonna wear out and get tired. And number two, it's gonna take much longer and eat into that working time. So if I can get it on much quicker, now I have more working time to get the panel on, get my gaps right, get it all fastened down. So big advantage as far as speed goes here. So let's get in and I'll show you this demonstration and we'll compare how much faster one application is to the other. Let's take a look at how this applicator is used, okay? So some unique features, things that you may not be used to. Again, first I'm going to glove up here. Now we are using adhesives as well here. So anytime we're talking about adhesives, panel bonding adhesives, structural adhesives, we want to be sure that we're consulting the OEM information to make sure we're using the right adhesive for the right vehicle, or even all the way down to the right adhesive for that particular panel on that vehicle. So always consult that information to make sure we don't make any errors there. That's a major safety issue. So you'll notice right away we have to take off this little plug on the end. The other thing to notice here is we've got a purple plug for the adhesives and the sealers, and the body filler has a red plug and a red nozzle. So purple plug, purple nozzle for the adhesives and sealers. Pretty easy to do. You don't want to use the wrong nozzle. It's not going to fit. It's going to leak. So once we have that off, I'm gonna put a respirator on, and what I'm gonna do here is you'll see I'll extrude some product out just to make sure it's coming out of both sides correctly, nothing's dried up and hardened in there or blocking it, okay? So I'm gonna extrude a little bit out, then I'm gonna attach my nozzle, run a little product out, and we'll be ready to use it, and we'll go into our demo. So as you can see, once I put that nozzle on, hopefully you can see that nozzle spinning inside, getting a really nice uniform mixture. Now, not only do we get a uniform mixture, but we get less air. So when it comes to body fillers, it's noticeably less pinholes. So I actually do a demonstration where I'll lay out a glob with this material and then one that's hand mixed. And once it gets kind of mostly cured, I cut it in half and you can look inside and see how nicely mixed and uniform mixture you get with the body fillers. So another big advantage. So now that we've got this all equalized, ready to go, let's set up for a demonstration here and I'll do a speed test side by side. So you can see a pretty significant improvement in how much material we got. You can also see that you get a much more uniform application, and my arm didn't wear out either. Again, if you're on a very large panel, your hand's gonna get really tired by the time you get this all applied. So good comparison where you see the difference between the two as far as ease of use. Hey, thanks for joining me for this video. I hope you picked up a couple of things. Feel free to like the video if you liked it. Also, you can leave comments below or questions. We actually do review those and try to get an answer back to you if we can. Be sure to hit the subscribe button and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Also, ding the little bell and you'll get notifications sent directly to you without having to go search for those. Also, for more content, more videos, etc., you can see our Collision Repair Academy as well, and we will leave a link to that in the description below. We'll see you next time.